Sharon Harris Berrun. I am a resident of Warren County, and I have actually lived in the Haliwa-Saponi community all of my life, previously living in the Halifax County area. Again, I've always lived in the community, and I guess I've always pretty much had a pretty good tie to the community and a strong role in the community. Growing up here, I started dancing at the age of 2, so I've always been culturally involved. And actually, I'm going to be 37 this year, and I've never missed a year, you know, dancing or being involved in the culture. As far as my role, I've always tried to be a role model for our Indian youth here in the community. Of course, in the community that we live in, we have to be role models for our youth. We have to provide activities to pull them in and try to pass our traditions on to them. So I guess within the community, I've really tried to keep the culture going within the tribe. I have worked for the tribe, the Haliwa-Saponi Tribe, for 16 years. This July 5th will be 16 years. And through my work with the tribe, I've had a great amount of youth come through our programs and tried to pass the traditions and cultures on to them through the programs that we provide, such as our TAPS program, as well as our regular culture classes that we have each Tuesday night. Well, I started doing artwork when I was really young. I guess you could say I started out with beadwork, pretty much. My mom taught me how to do beadwork at a really young age, probably around the age of maybe 7 or 8. And from that, being interested in the culture and dancing, I just went from one thing to the next. Basically, I focus right now on doing all sorts of regalia. And with doing regalias, I do a lot of sewing applique. This is a artwork that has really come a long ways over the years. It's done, you know, definitely intricate designs. And I usually try to find something out about a person before I take on doing their regalias. I guess that's how I would consider my artwork a little different too, because anybody who comes to me and says, well, you know, I like to have a regalia done and I understand you do them, then I sit down and talk with them because I like to incorporate something into their design that brings out their personality, whether it be in the color or whether the design itself. With the applique work, there are lots of different things that you can use. It's not really any type of particular material that you have to use for any of the regalias. I guess as you can see, most of the stuff that I have today is done in sequins, but you can use cotton materials, also satin materials. Also use what is called a heat and bond. The heat and bond is actually used to draw your design. It's a paper that you iron on the back of your material, and then you draw your design onto that paper, and that's how we end up getting the designs to actually stick to the material. It's just ironed right on after you draw them on and cut them out. You iron them on, and then of course I use the sewing machine to do the what we call the zigzag effect or the applique onto the regalias. I just feel that, you know, everything, all of my artwork that I do, I put my all into it. You know, I put a lot of love, a lot of prayers in it, you know, because sometimes, you know, you get frustrated. Things go wrong, especially when you're dealing with the applique work and having to work with the sewing machine or what have you. But it's a lot of love that goes into it. It's a, you know, I've put a lot of love and effort into our community, and I'm hoping, you know, that one day, you know, when I'm not here anymore, somebody can look back on my artwork or, you know, look back on some of the children that we've had in our community and say, well, you know, they were influenced in a positive way by Sharon or, you know, whoever it is, just as long as, you know, we can leave our mark here and say that we did all we could in our community and or in our state, even, you know, for the good of the Indian people.